God's been in my life today, to the pastor and first lady of this house. I thank God for being here today. And if I would have to title what I have to say, it would be, don't get it twisted. Meekness is not weakness. So my fruit is gentleness, and I feel like gentleness and meekness go hand in hand. So I'll be interchanging both of them. Gentleness is the definition, and the definition of gentleness is sensitivity of disposition and kindness of behavior, founded on strength promoted by love. Meekness is an attribute of human nature and behavior. Humbleness, patient, long-suffering, you restrain your own power to allow room for others. So the Greek word for gentleness is praxis, and it means gentle strength expressing power with reserve and gentleness, mildness. So meekness begins with the Lord's inspiration, and it finishes by his direction and empowerment. It's a virtue that only can operate through faith. And how many people know that it takes faith to be gentle and to be meek and to restrain yourself for the sake of somebody else?
My God.
I know that it takes faith for me. And when I was careful when choosing my fruit, because last year I chose love, and I got tested in love up until the day of me speaking. And when I chose gentleness, I said, uh-oh, I'm like, it's coming, and it's definitely been there. But it takes more strength to go high when somebody else goes low. A gentle person is strong, but it's done in love. So if you don't love, you cannot be gentle. And too many people confuse gentle with weak, but that's not the case. And so you say, well, what does that mean? Gentleness is a strong hand with a soft touch. It is a tender and compassionate approach towards others' weaknesses. Yes. So a gentle person, they speak the truth. It may be painful, but in doing so, they guard their tone so the truth will be well received. Wow. So true followers of Christ, they're distinguished by their gentleness. So Philippians 4 and 5 says, let your gentleness be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. So that scripture means that we're supposed to be gentle to those outside the church, not just fellow believers. We're not supposed to seek revenge against those who treat us unfairly, nor are we supposed to be overly vocal about our own personal rights. So we shouldn't be easily angered, but reasonable with people who can handle, but we're supposed to be reasonable people who can handle difficulties and disagreements with maturity. So then you may say, well, Teonna, what do I do when conflict arises? Proverbs 15 and 1. A soft answer turns away wrath, but harsh words So have you tried to argue with somebody in a whisper? Probably not. It's equally as hard to argue with somebody who insists on answering gently. So on the other hand, a rising voice in harsh words almost always trigger an angry response. So to turn away wrath, we should seek peace and use gentle words. So for me, my example of this is at my job, I take phone calls, and sometimes I get angry taxpayers, and they call me every name in the book. And in particular, I had this gentleman, he was just going in on me, and I'm like, Lord Jesus, I ain't done nothing to this man. And I mean, he was calling me out my name, and when I say calling me, he was calling me all sorts of things, and it was you people this and all types of stuff. But instead, I kept answering him, sir, if you don't lower your voice, I'm going to have to hang up the phone. And he just kept going, and I kept saying, sir, I'm trying to assist you, but you have to lower your voice. And finally, he allowed me to assist him. And he said, at the end of the conversation, he said, thank you. I said, I apologize to you for cursing you out on the phone. But you know what kept me going on the phone? And I said, what? He said, because you had a nice answer every time I gave you something harsh. So I was able to turn that conversation around with a soft answer. And we should all try to do that the same way. So Ephesians 4 and 2 says, with all lowliness and gentleness, with long suffering, bearing one another in love. Nobody is perfect, And so we're to love other Christians despite their faults. We're to be patient and gentle with people. It doesn't burn me up any more than folks who act like they got it all together and that they stuff don't stink like everybody else's. That makes me so angry. And we all got some things that we can work on and do better. So here's my confession. My name is Teonna Clay. I am P-E-T-T-Y. My attitude stinks sometimes. I'm a bad wife and mom sometimes, and I have issues with the capital I. But that's okay, because God loves me and I'm still working on me, and we have to learn how to love people where they are. So here's a quote from one of my favorite movies. It says, "The world ain't all sunshines and rainbows. It is very a mean and nasty place. It will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is going to hit as hard as life does. But it ain't how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep on moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hit and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you are because of him, her, or nobody. Cowards do that, and that's not you. You're better than that." And that's from Rocky. I love Rocky because Rocky keep going. So, you know what? If you see somebody's fault, pray for them. Don't judge them. Don't put them down. And if you can help them, help them. And I try to live by these words. If they're bleeding, I'm not going to keep eating my salad and just let them bleed. I don't care if it's an enemy or whatever. I learned in a situation where somebody was coming against me, and when they needed help, you know what? I still helped them regardless of what they did to me, because God's going to judge me on what I did, what they did to me.
That's right.
So just remember, don't get it twisted. Meekness is not weakness. It's strength under control.
Hey!